ऑफ वाटर, ड्रिंकिंग वाटर इज क्लियर, कलरलेस एंड विदाउट अ डिसअग्रीएबल टेस्ट और ऑर्डर. दिस इज द आइडियल ड्रिंकिंग वाटर. सम ऑफ द सैप्रोफेटिक बैक्टीरिया प्रेजेंट इन द ड्रिंकिंग वाटर इंक्लूड सूडोमोनास, सेरेशिया, फ्लेवोबैक्टीरियम, क्रोमोबैक्टीरियम, एसिनिटोबैक्टर एंड एल्कलीजेंस. दे आर सैप्रोफाइटिक सो दे डू नॉट कॉज एनी डिसीज. ओनली द पैथोजेंस विच आर इंट्रोड्यूस्ड इन टू द वाटर पोल्यूटेड बाई एक्सक्रीटा और सुवेज पोस ए रिस्क टू द ह्यूमन्स. Some of the pathogenic organisms are given here. Firstly, in the community, bacteria which are pathogenic include Shigella species, Vibrio cholerae, Salmonella enterica, serotypes typhi and paratyphi A, B and C, and Leptospira species. Next is parasites. Protozoa include Giardia lamblia and Entamoeba histolytica and the helminths Schistosoma hematobium and Dracunculus melanensis. Lastly, the viruses like enteroviruses. In the hospital, the pathogenic bacteria are Legionella pneumophila, Serratia Marksens, Mycobacterium xenopi, Pseudomonas possimobilis, Mycobacterium chiloni, Acinetobacter species, Pseudomonas aeruginosa, and Clostridium difficile. Let's see about the bacteriological examination of the water. So here, water is tested for fecal pollution by detecting the presence of coliform bacteria. The coliform bacteria are those which are present in the human intestine. Coliform stands for colon. So these are easily detected even in high dilutions. And it is confirmed by the detection of thermotolerant Escherichia coli, which is a definite proof for fecal contamination of the water. Other bacteria include fecal streptococci and Clostridium perfringens. So the test for fecal pollution is by the detection of coliform bacteria. Confirmation is the presence of Escherichia coli. Other bacteria are fecal streptococci and Clostridium perfringens. Let's see the tests done for routine bacteriological analysis of the water. First is plate count. Principle. Count is made of the number of colonies formed in the pore plate cultures of water samples on the nutrient agar incubated aerobically in parallel at 37 degrees Celsius for 1 to 2 days and at 22 degrees Celsius for 3 days. So here the bacteria growing at 37 degrees Celsius, that is the body temperature, are the ones associated with organic material of human or animal origin, whereas the bacteria growing at 22 degrees Celsius at lab temperature, they are usually saprobic, normally inhabit water or derived from soil and vegetables. So the bacteria growing under 37 degrees Celsius are usually pathogenic. Next is interpretation of plate count. The plate count at 22 degrees Celsius is the indication of quantity of decomposing organic matter in the water. The greater the amount of organic matter, more likely the water is to be contaminated with parasitic and pathogenic organisms. The plate count at 37 degrees Celsius is an important index of dangerous pollution. Next is the detection of coliform bacteria and Escherichia coli. First method is presumptive coliform count by using multiple tube technique. Principle: an estimate of the number of coliform organisms is usually made by adding variable quantities of water from 0.1 to 50 ml to bile salt lactose peptone water with an indicator for acidity. So the medium used is bile salt lactose peptone water. Alternate medium include double strength McConkie's broth. So this is just for a presumption. So here acid and gas formation indicates the growth of coliforms. McConkie fluid medium, which is modified, is used for the procedure. Interpretation of the result: the probable number of coliforms per 100 ml is read from the probability tables of McCrady. This is known as presumptive coliform count or most probable number of coliforms. So the number of coliforms per 100 ml is called as presumptive coliform count or most probable number of coliforms. So class 1 is when the water is excellent, that is the presumptive coliform count per 100 ml is 0 and the E. coli count per 100 ml is also 0. Next is class 2, when the water is satisfactory, the presumptive coliform count per 100 ml is 1 to 3, whereas the E. coli count per 100 ml is 0. Class 3, when the water is suspicious, presumptive coliform count per 100 ml is 4 to 10 and the E. coli count per 100 ml is 0. Class 4 is when the water is unsatisfactory, that is when presumptive coliform count per 100 ml is more than 10 and the E. coli count per 100 ml is 0.1 or more than that. Next method is differential coliform test, called as Aeschmann test. The principle of this test is to determine whether the coliform bacilli detected in the presumptive test are E. coli or not. Methodology: following the presumptive test, the subcultures are made from all the bottles showing acid and gas, that is positive result, to fresh tubes of single strength McConkie medium, which is pre-warmed to 37 degrees Celsius. This is the method for differential coliform test. Interpretation: the tubes exhibiting gas in the Durham's tube are deemed to contain E. coli, and the presence of E. coli can be further confirmed by testing for indole production and citrate utilization. The next method is membrane filtration method. The principle: a measured volume of water is filtered through a membrane filter with a pore size of 22 micrometer, which are bacteria stopping filters. So the bacteria, if present, are retained on the surface of the filter. So here the filter used is membrane filter. The third is detection of fecal streptococci. Principle: fecal streptococci, which is Enterococcus species, may be present in the water samples, but they are present usually for only short durations. So this means that if the fecal streptococci are detected in the water sample, it suggests recent fecal contamination of the water, as it is short-lived. Methodology for detection of fecal streptococci: all the positive bottles in the presumptive coliform test are subcultured to the tubes containing 5 ml of glucose azide broth and incubated at 45 degrees Celsius. So here the media used is 5 ml of glucose azide broth. If the fecal streptococci are detected in a water sample, it suggests recent fecal contamination of the water, as you have seen in the previous point. Here, the growth is indicated by the presence of acid in the medium within 18 hours of incubation. The organism detected is Enterococcus faecalis. So, as it is present in water samples for only short durations, its detection indicates recent fecal contamination of the water. Positive tubes are plated onto McConkie's agar for confirmation. Next is detection of Clostridium perfringens. Principal use for this test: if Clostridium perfringens alone is detected in a water sample without the presence of E. coli or fecal streptococci, it suggests fecal contamination that is not recent. So if only Clostridium perfringens is present without E. coli or fecal streptococci, this indicates that the fecal contamination is not recent. Methodology: varying quantities of water samples are incubated in litmus milk medium anaerobically at 37 degrees Celsius for 5 days. Stomy clot formation is looked for to infer the presence of Clostridium perfringens. So there is stomy clot appearance, which indicates the presence of Clostridium perfringens. Last is the test for pathogenic bacteria like typhoid bacilli or cholera vibrios. The method which was formerly performed is by adding water samples to 10-fold concentrated liquid media, incubating and finally subculturing onto appropriate solid media. So previously, the method performed was by adding water samples to 10-fold concentration liquid media, incubating and finally subculturing onto appropriate solid media. But nowadays, a simpler and more sensitive method is used, which is to filter the water sample through membrane filters and then incubate the filters on appropriate solid media. So the filtration done using membrane filter is a simpler and more sensitive method for testing pathogenic bacteria. So this is about the bacteriology of water. Thank you.